And because of you only, you regular four or five participants who encouraged me to complete the paper. Surbhi, Mukesh, Pinky, these three are regular students. No, let's sir, hope today. Yes, Mukesh.
Sir, rather I would say that I am the privileged one to be learned from you, sir. And the thankful to RC Bhuvneshwar also, sir. They have supported us a lot, sir.
Yeah, from your feedback, I can only say.
Our privilege to get the classes from you. I mean, for me especially, it is very helpful to, you know, get these classes. And get you know, so much knowledge from people like you.
Well, thank you, Surbhi, so much. Actually, whatever little knowledge I have, I will try to deliver it to you. So, not that much knowledgeable like all other learned persons who are there in the industry. Still then, because of you people, I feel encouraged. I get motivated to take online sessions of 2 hours. Actually, it takes a lot of effort from your part as well as from my part also. So, let us move into the last unit, the last block. And the last block, what I saw in your book, it is a huge block comprising of more than 90 pages. So when I actually, I thought how to cover this. But later on, I realized many of the things are revised in this particular block. So during the course, during the coverage of this particular block, we'll be revising some of the things. So nothing to worry. I think within the stipulated time, we'll be able to complete this block. So without any further delay, I think we'll start. But before that, today we have four participants. I want to at least have a glimpse of my participants for the first and last time. So let me first be on video so that you can see me. Thereafter, I want to see at least some of you, then we will proceed. Yes, Mukesh, am I visible to you?
Yes,
big,
sir.
Bald head.
Sir, apna ko to mane hello.
Kuntu.
Sir.
Pinky.
Apna, sir. Again, sir. Pinky, sir.
Kon ko chho ko Pinky.
Sir, apna puri ro na.
Tame.
Sir, movie puri ro.
Toh bola la.
Yeah.
वही तो अच्छी है एसएस कॉलेज रे अच्छी एमबीए डिपार्टमेंट रे तो केवे दरकार की चाहो से पहले बैठो ही पड़ेगा
आगे
ओके ओके
अपन एसएस रे अच्छा दिन है आगे ओके सर
तो मुकेश आई वांट टू सी यू वंस Yes, I can see you now. Yes, yes. You are having specs like me, but the biggest difference is your hair on the head. I don't have many, but you have plenty. And Surbhi, please come on video. I can see half of your face, not your full face. Yeah, now I can see you. Thanks a lot. Looks like a yoga guru. Maintaining a good figure. What it seems to me. Then who else is left? Pinky. Pinky is gone offline. Okay, then let us start today. Yeah, Pinky has now come back. Pinky, would you like to show your face? Please be on video. No, I think there is some network problem with her. Every time she is trying to get in video, she is getting disconnected. Okay, then during some point of time, we'll be getting a glimpse of her. So let us start today. Actually, the last block, it says about the promotion decision. Promotion decision means the business promotion decision. The decisions which should be taken to promote your business. Promotion of business means you want to raise your sales. You want to establish a good brand name of yours. You want to create a good image of your product as well as your organization. In all these regards, you will definitely want a message from your organization or from your product to reach the customers effectively. For that, a marketing communication is essential. In fact, to satisfy all your objectives, an effective marketing communication is of utmost importance. Then what is a marketing communication? As you know, communication, similarly, marketing communication, this is a systematic way of circulating the relevant marketing information. By whom? By the organization. To whom? To the target market, to the target consumers. So marketing communication is a systematic process of circulating marketing information, specific marketing information by an organization to its target market. Then what would be the importance? As you have already guessed it, the first function of marketing communication will be to provide information about your organization and your product. And the communication should be done in a way so that it will pursue the target consumers, the target customers, to go for your product. That will be the first function of marketing communication. Then of course, other functions like providing information when a new product or brand is introduced in the market. Information need to reach people. Of course, marketing communication is also required for those consumers who have proven themselves to be already loyal to a brand. They also need the marketing communication to reach them at a regular interval of time. Otherwise, the image they have conceived in their mind about an organization will fade away. So for that reason, it needs consistent communication to reach the consumers. Now, how does this communication process take place? This is a very common general thing to know. For any communication process, whether you are doing it with a friend, communication process, it will first start from a sender. Sender will send a message. Sender will try to intimate a message in his way. In his way means the sender will want to send a message which will involve his thoughts, his ideas. He may send it in text, he may send it through some symbols, but the main part is that the main objective in sending the message, designing the message, is that it should be properly understood by the receiver. So in between the sender and receiver, three things take place. One is whatever thoughts, ideas, information the sender is sending or is trying to communicate should reach the target audience, the target segment, either in verbal form or in non-verbal form, in oral form or written form or symbolic form, it should reach the target audience, of course, through a particular medium which we will be discussing later, which we generally called media, either through the newspaper, the print media or the electronics media, or there are some other means also. We'll be discussing about that a bit later. But first, sender creates an idea, then puts it into some words or symbols, then chooses a medium through which it will be transmitted to the receiver. Once the receiver receives the message, the receiver must also understand the inherent meaning of the message. Unless the receiver understands the message in a complete way, then I think the communication will not be considered as a successful communication. Whatever the sender wished to send or wished to communicate, in the same way, the receiver must understand that. After the receiver, let us assume the receiver understands it correctly, then the receiver will give a reaction. That is known as a response. It will be either it will be positive or it will be negative, but the receiver will give a reaction, which is known as response. These response are collected through different survey, through marketing personnel, so that this feedback can be converted into positive sales. And if the content or the inherent thought within the message does not reach the target consumer properly, then the communication will not be considered successful, and the disturbance, the interference for which the communication or the meaning, the thought, the idea could not reach the target consumer properly within the process, this disturbance is called noise. In marketing term, this is called noise. Noise means due to some interference, due to some distortion, the meaning of the message could not be successfully transferred or understood by the target consumer. Then question will come, how we can develop effective marketing communication? For developing any effective marketing communication, first there are some steps, and by the time you must have an idea how to design a system, how to develop an effective system. In developing a system, first you have to identify the audience, the target audience, the target consumers, and recognize, understand their characteristics. Once you finalize on the target audience, then you determine the communication objectives. The communication objectives means, let me give some examples. Suppose a new product is going to be introduced, and the consumers, they are totally unaware of this product. So in this case, your communication objective will be to build awareness and knowledge among them. Similarly, if your product already exists in the market, the target audience is aware of your product, then the objective of communication will be to build linking or to build conviction. The objective of the communication will be to more convince them about your product, as then they know your product for a long time. They will be convinced that yes, this is a product which has been existing for a long time, because the marketing communication is very persuasive. We should at least try this product. These are the steps, these are the objectives at different stages of a product. Now, after you identify the audience, target audience, after you determine the communication objective, now you have to design an effective message. An effective message means what you will say to the customers, or what you are trying to say to the target consumers, how it will be represented to the consumers. What you want to say, how you will present it. So in that regard, you have a lot of companies, they take different things into consideration. Some companies, they go for a rational approach. Rational approach means which seems very logical. This is mostly applicable for the durable consumer goods like refrigerators, air conditioners, washing machines. It depends on the product. Some organizations, they go for emotional appeals, emotional approach, so that it will touch you and you will be interested to purchase that particular product or service. The best example is your life insurance. It is purely an emotional approach. And some organizations, they also want to communicate on moral basis, moral appeal or moral approach. That means their message will communicate to maintain a clean environment. Their message will be to promote equal rights for women in their message. So these are some of the approaches which the organizations follow to communicate to the target consumers. Then actually they think of formatting, they think of building a message which will be easy for the consumers to understand. At the same time, it will be appealing, it will be persuasive, either from the rational point of view or from emotional point of view or from a moral point of view. Now the final thing is, when it will be presented, how the organization wants to present it, whether some background voice will tell about the message, or whether it will be presented by an eminent personality of a specific field. This particular aspect is known as message force, message source. Message source means through whom you are delivering, you are presenting the message to the audience. So, in this regard, usually the organizations, they go for some celebrities, they go for eminent personalities, eminent sportsmen to present their thoughts and ideas to actually communicate the message to the target audience. That's why you see Amitabh Bachchan in a lot of advertisement. You see Dhoni, you see Virat Kohli. Even now also you see Saurabh Ganguly, who was supposed to be the aggressive captain for India. Now you have decided on the message, what to say and how to present. Then you have to select the communication channel. That means the media, the medium through which you will be placing, you will be presenting your message. So there are different channels. One is known as personal communication channels. Personal communication channels means you will be interacting individually with persons. It may be through email, it may be through telephone, it may be by meeting someone physically. But through personal communication channel, you will not be able to cover a larger population within a shorter period of time. In that regard, a non-personal communication channel is preferred. What is a non-personal communication channel? That means you don't have to interact with individuals personally. You will put your message through such a medium that within a very short period of time, it will cover a large population or it will reach a large population. So you can do it through print media, which comprises of your newspaper. You can do it through your electronics media, like your TV. You can use broadcasting media. These are non-personal communication channels. And there are some other means also, through some social welfare events, an organization can promote its name and so also an image for its product, through some cultural activities, through some exhibitions, through press conference. Suppose an organization is supposed to launch a new product, it can call a press conference and describe about its new product. In the non-personal communication channels, a larger number of consumers are communicated within a short span of time. So this is basically your marketing communication. And what we have discussed so far, the functions of marketing communication and the elements within the communication process, from the sender to the receiver, after getting his response, feedback, how you will convert yourself, how will you convert your lead into sales. Then you can design an effective marketing communication. How to structure your message and how to present your message. Then you have the option to choose from different channels, from personal communication channels to non-personal communication channels. Now we will be talking about promotion mix. Promotion mix means the total range of tools that are available to the organization, to the communicator, to make a persuasive communication. Promotion mix can be defined as a range of tools, as varieties of tools, available tools, which the communicator uses to make a persuasive communication regarding its product or its brand. As you know, mix means several different things will be combined together. Similarly, in a promotion mix, you have different elements, or promotion mix can be done through two or more of these elements. All the elements may not be taken together, but definitely there will be two or more than two of these elements which will be present in the promotion mix. The first one is your advertising. What is advertising? Advertising is nothing but a paid form of non-personal communication through mass media, either about a product or a service. Advertising is always a paid form, and it is always done through non-personal communications medium. That means either it will be on the print media or in the electronics media. Then, what are the characteristics the advertising has? Advertising has basically four characteristics. Advertising makes a presentation of the product before the public. It tells about the quality of the product or spreads the quality of the product throughout the target audience. Then, through advertisement, we can enhance the unique feature of product by repeatedly reaching to the customers, because if the advertisement goes on from time to time, if it is repeated on a particular newspaper or a TV channel, then the unique feature will occupy more place in the consumer's mind. That is known as amplified expressiveness. So these are some of the characteristics of advertising. It will make a presentation of the product before the public. It will spread the good quality of the product among them, and also by its repetitive nature, it will amplify its uniqueness. This is one of the components of promotion mix. Another component is your sales promotion. What is a sales promotion? Sales promotion is a variety of short-term incentives announced to encourage the purchase of a product or a service. Why it is short-term? That means these incentives will be for a certain period of time. It will not be available anytime throughout the year. Like you can take some examples. Sales for promoting sales, that is discount on woolen garments in the hot days. Similarly, some discounts are given on refrigerators and air conditioners on winter days. So that is actually a tactic to promote sales. But whatever discounts they are offering, that message should reach the customers so that they will be aware they will be tempted to purchase the product before actually their requirement, so that they can purchase the product 6 months in advance, so that they would be able to save some money for them. That will be a temptation for them. Similarly, there is another component which is known as public relation and publicity. Let us discuss this public relation and publicity at a later part, because for advertising you have to spend, for sales promotion also you are giving discounts, means you are spending, you are not getting the actual price of the product for the time being, so that is also a cost for the organization. Another component is your personal selling. What is personal selling? As you can imagine from the name, personal selling is the oral presentation of a person in conversation with one or more prospective buyers for the purpose of making sales. You just take the example of the salesman of a vacuum cleaner who comes to your doorstep and pursues you to purchase a vacuum cleaner. That means at that time the person is orally giving a presentation of the product before you or your family members for the purpose of making a sale. Another component in the promotion mix is your direct marketing. Direct marketing means you will find a way to reach the customer directly, so that there will be no intermediary in between. The customer will get the product directly from the organization, from the industry or from the company, so that it will be beneficial for the customer to get this product at a less price. Direct marketing can be done through your internet, through emails, through telephoning different consumers. So this is direct marketing. Now we will come to the last component, which is known as public relation and publicity. Now from this time I can differentiate, I can give you the differentiation between between your advertising and publicity, so that we will not be covering that in the end. For advertising, you have to pay, you have to spend, you have to pay. For publicity, what happens in publicity? You will not pay a newspaper for your publicity. Publicity comes when you are doing some activities other than the ordinary activities. That means, suppose you are doing a socio welfare work under the banner of your organization, that will be automatically covered by the media and that will give you publicity. Suppose you are felicitating some of the brilliant students in a school in an annual function courtesy your organization, that will be covered by the media automatically. That will be a publicity for your organization. So you don't have to pay the media for publication. Whatever they observe, they think, they visualize, they will publish it from their side. In that case, it is called publicity.
Sir, can
so
we
when
say,
difference yes, Mukesh.
Sir, can we say the Ramdev is getting too much publicity because of Corona bill? He wanted to advertise, but now he is getting more publicity.
In which form you can? Yes, you are going in the right direction, but give me an example so that I can differentiate.
Sir, we can say basically publicity is negative advertisement, which is not paid by the person, the sponsor.
No, it's not a negative advertisement, Mukesh. Sorry to interrupt you.
Yes, sir.
Both the purpose of, just let me speak for a minute, then you will speak your version, you will present your version. Both the things, advertisement and publicity, are meant for the betterment of the organization. Of course, if you are doing something ill, if you are undertaking a bad practice, then automatically you will get a negative publicity which will hamper the reputation of your organization. But if we are organizing some social welfare events, if we are felicitating some of the brilliant students, if you are supporting a good cause to save the environment, then the publicity we get will be a constructive one. So you cannot say publicity is the negative advertisement. Rather, let me give you another example so that you can understand it very clearly. You must have seen the program Aapki Adalat on India TV.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes. Then those celebrities who come to the program, that is automatically covered and telecast in the channel. So to attend that program, they are not paying. It is an invitation from the channel whether you are interested to attend this program or not. If they are interested, they attend the program and they get free publicity.
So we can add publicity can be favorable if we have effective personal relation department, I think.
Yes, that is true. Publicity will be favorable if you have a very good public relation department, and actually if you are following a good practice, you will be getting a good publicity. If you are doing negative things, illegal things, you will at the same time you will get the adverse publicity, negative publicity. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
So these are the components of promotion mix, like advertising, sales promotion, personal selling, direct marketing, and your publicity, public relation and publicity. Now others, let me ask you whether whatever I have explained so far, whether it is understood to you or not, and whether I am clearly audible to you or not.
Yes, sir, you are. Just a question, sir. Then, so what is, there's one thing known as marketing mix. So what is the primary difference between marketing mix and promotion mix?
Now you tell me, what are the elements of marketing mix?
Marketing mixes are the way the product is being marketed in the, the distributed in the market.
Well, in marketing mix, actually, you are the four P's are important.
In yes, sir. Promotion, you are spending, product, and yes, sir. Four P's. Yeah.
Now you get into the track. Product.
Yeah.
Price, place, and promotion. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, what you have asked me about promotion mix. So, marketing mix has a greater domain, in which product mix is a very small part.
Yeah, that's what I was having the thing in my mind, that promotion mix is a part of marketing mix only, right?
Yes. Promotion mix is a part of your promotion, that means your advertisement, your business communication, marketing communication. So it actually falls into the bigger set of total marketing mix. It's a very small part of marketing mix.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Whatever we have discussed so far, promotion mix, we have discussed five elements, five components. So, any organization, they can go for two or more than two. It is not compulsory for all the organizations to adopt all the five components to make their communication, to make their promotion mix. It depends on the organization, how much they can afford, what steps they can do to do these things. Okay, it is not compulsory that every organization will make a promotion mix comprising of all these five components. Okay, Surbhi.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Now, your same question will lead me to those factors who are affecting the promotion mix. So there are factors relating to different aspects. There will be some product specific factors which will be affecting the promotion mix. Product specific factor means whether the product information is simple or complex, in which stage the product is in its product life cycle. Like we have discussed, if it is in initial stage, it is the advertisement, the communication will be done to create more awareness and knowledge. If it is in the growth stage, then the differentiation or the uniqueness of that product should be repeatedly done so that the consumers will be aware of that and the consumers will feel privileged to have that product. So it, from the product specific factors, the promotion mix can be done. Similarly, from customer point of view, there are some customer specific factors. Customer specific factors means which target, which segment you are targeting, what are their characteristics, which type of product will suit their taste, which type of message, which type of communication will they be able to understand, that we have significance. Similarly, from company is point of view, there will be some specific factors which will affect the promotion mix. Let me give you an example of company specific factors. That is a strategy adopted by many of the sales organizations that is known as push strategy. Push strategy means the organization or the manufacturer will try to push its product through distribution channels. It will give pressure to the distribution channels to push their product to increase the sales of their product. This doesn't happen for all the organizations. This only happens for the organizations which are supposed to be very much established. They are fit in the market. Because the distributor will never want to lose association with that organization. That is a reputed organization, and the distributor doesn't want to lose relation with that organization. That is called your push strategy. That means pushing for more sales. There is also another strategy which is known as pull strategy. Pull strategy means it involves a high degree of advertising. This high degree of advertising is actually helping the distributor to increase their sales, to reach more number of consumers. That means the organization is doing a complementary work for the distributor to increase sales. So pull strategy is very much always welcomed by the intermediaries, because in this strategy, the marketer, they focus on promotional efforts. They take some responsibility from their part to increase the sales. Similarly, there are other factors from the company's point of view. One factor is your budget consideration. All the promotional mix will be done only if the budget allows all those components to be included. So budget plays a significant role. So these are the factors from company's point of view which affect a promotion mix, like your budget, like your push strategy, pull strategy. Now from there is another aspect which is known as situation specific factor. Situation specific factor means how the public visualize the company. From that context also promotion mix is done. How the public visualize the company. Let me give you some names. Tata's, Hindustan Unilever. So whenever I utter these brand names, you certainly have some image of these organizations in your mind. That is called public visualization of companies. And for those companies, they, whatever advertisement, whatever communication they want to make to you, you always appreciate that, because in all their messages, they try to communicate you to give a good value for your money, and their image, as they are involved in various social and environmental activities, their image is also getting big in the public eyes. Similarly, situation-specific factors can lead to extent of competition, where there is a stiff competition, promotional activities will be carried out by the organizations which are in competition with one another. Now the last thing which we discussed just before, situation-specific factors, from company's point of view, budget is important. As per the budget, the promotion mix is settled or is determined. Actually, we will know how the budgeting, promotion budgeting method is, how the promotion budgeting is done, and what are the methods, what are the approaches through which it is done. Let me brief you with some very specific and short lines. This promotion budgeting is done through two or three very popular methods. One is your affordable method. Affordable method simply means the company determines the amount which it can spend after all the expenses in production and operation. That means after the main expenses in production and operation, whatever they have with them, they will spend that for promotion needs. Some other companies, they go for percentage of sales. That means whatever their sales was in the last year, was in the previous financial year, they determine a specific percentage of that sales to be diverted towards promotion needs. The extended version of percentage of sales is unit of sales method. That means here the percentage of sales will not be taken into consideration. Here the unit of sales, number of products sold, will be taken into consideration. The process is same. There a percentage is calculated on the total sales. Here every product, suppose for every product sold, the company, the organization has 10 rupees to be diverted towards promotion. So if 1000 units are sold, they will be having 10,000 as fund, as budget. If 1 lakh units are sold, then they will be having 10 lakh as the fund for promotion mix. So this is just an extended version of unit of percentage of sales. This is known as unit of sales method. Then there is another method which is known as competitive parity method. Just listen the name, competitive parity method. That means in this method, the budget will be allocated as per the budget of the competitors. Suppose you are in competition with another manufacturer, they are occupying 30% of the market, you have occupied 20% of the market. If they are spending 30 lakhs for their sales promotion or promotion mix, as per your market share 20%, you will also be spending 20 lakhs for the promotion mix. Proportionately, this will be done by looking at your competitor on their expenses on promotion mix. So these, all these methods, affordable method, percentage of sales method, unit of sales method, comparative parity method, all these methods come under top-down approaches. Top-down approaches. Why these approaches are known as top-down approaches? Because these approaches start from the top-level management, which the top-level management that decides about all these methods to which they will be following. There is another approach which is known as build-up approach. Build-up approach means you want to achieve a certain objective, you want to achieve a certain market share. In that regard, whatever needed, the supporting activities, right from the supporting activities to your production, to your market, to your marketing communication, advertisement, whatever is needed to achieve that objectives, that will be, all will be taken into consideration to build up a budget. That means it is not a percentage of sales. It is not a, it is not based on the competitor's expenses. It is not based on affordability. But it is decided as per the requirement of the organization. So this is called build-up approach. That means you will build a budget to achieve the objectives. So you can go through them, not difficult to understand. Now we will be discussing about interesting marketing communication, which is known as integrated marketing communication. Nowadays, this integrated marketing communication is adopted by most of the organizations who can afford all the components of promotion mix. They take sales promotion, direct marketing, public relation, publicity, event sponsorship, everything within their promotion mix to create a good image of their organization, to establish their brand name, and to increase their sales. When all the components of the promotion mix are taken together to promote your organization, to promote yourself, then the communication is known as integrated marketing communication. That means by following all the means, they try to reach larger number of customers so that their sales will go up. So this is all about your marketing communication. Hope I am able to clear the minimum basic fundamental things, fundamental concept of marketing communication. If anyone having any doubt can ask me or shall I move forward?
No, sir, no doubt so far.
Shall I move forward? Okay, Surbhi. Pinky.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then. Now we will move to some specific component of marketing mix. Personal selling and sales promotion. As you know, personal selling means you have to interact with your customers personally. Personal selling is one of the oldest methods of business promotion. Through personal selling, efforts are made to stimulate the consumption process of a consumer. That means to tempt a consumer to purchase your product. That is for your consumer durables, consumer goods. And in case of industrial products, heavy products, for whom you know there would be small number of buyers, but the order size will be big from each buyer. So for those industrial products, personal selling is a must. Unless you approach an organization, unless you get in touch with the top management of that organization, you will not be able to get your product through to that organization. You will not be able to sell your product at all in a bulk to that organization. So personal selling, in under which situation it will be conducive? Personal selling will be very fruitful if we consider it from the product point of view. When the product is new, it will be helpful. Yes, of course, like the industrial products, when the product is of high unit value, it will be useful. And it is also useful for those products. Personal selling will be useful to them. Those who, the products which are having no brand name, very local product, but with good quality. Personal selling will be the best means to reach the customer. Similarly, if we consider the market situation, personal selling will be fruitful when you don't get the desired intermediary. Also, it will be helpful when the company is selling to a small number of buyers and the buyers are large buyers. Their number is small, but they are purchasing in bulk. Similarly, from company's point of view, if the company doesn't have sufficient fund to allocate for all the components of promotional mix, they go for personal selling. Because in personal selling, what happens? The person who is associated with it or who will be doing the sales, he will, in most of the cases, he is not in the payroll of the company. Whatever he will sell, he will be getting a commission for that. So, more he sells, more commission he will get. On that basis, it works. So, the company doesn't have an obligation to pay a salary to that particular person. So, when the funds are low, the company appoints this personal seller. Then selling jobs, types of selling jobs, many types of selling jobs are there. Let me just discuss two or three. One is merchandise deliveries, the jobs that are performed by delivery boy. They are called merchandise deliveries. That means the salesperson whose primary job is to deliver the product against a routine order. That means suppose you have an organization and you have regular order from different hotels. So the person who is delivering or executing the order, delivering the goods to those to the hotels, is a delivery boy, and he comes under merchandise deliveries. Similarly, there is inside order takers. Inside order taker means the salesman or the retailer who is giving you product as per your order, as per your wish. Similarly, there are outside order takers. Outside order taker means these persons are engaged in the assignment of procuring orders from resellers. That means procuring orders from the wholesaler, so that they will communicate it to the manufacturer. These are some types of selling jobs which will be of not much importance. But selling process, there may be a question on selling process. A question will come in from describe the steps involved in a selling process. If you have your material, if you have book, then it is a table in which selling process is briefly described. Don't go through all the description under all these steps to memorize. Just look at the table. It is in your last block. That table, if you understand that table, it will be enough for you to present the selling process in the paper. Let me just go through it quickly. it starts from the downward. That means first step is preparation, second is prospecting, third is pre-approach, that means preparation before approaching the consumer, then approach, sales presentation, objection handling, then closing the sale, and post follow-up. If you just go through this table, it will be enough for you to understand. Preparation, that means if you are getting prepared for an examination, you have to study, you have to understand the paper. The more you understand the paper well, the more you are supposed to do or present yourself in the exam. For any preparation, you know null. You have to get knowledge. And for marketing, you have to get knowledge on your product, your customers, your competitors, and your company. Prospecting means when your survey team will give you data about, so let us assume 1,000 people. Your survey team have given you, team has given you data. So from those 1,000 persons with whom the survey has been carried out, you have to separate the prospects. That means with which you have the opportunity, or at least you have the scope to do business, to go ahead. Because all the persons will not be taking interest in your product. Those persons who have taken interest in your organization or in your product, you have separated them. You have to separate them from the other lot and focus on those customers only. They are called prospects. Then before you approach, you have to study the consumers who are regularly buying from your organization so that you can relate them to the new prospects. Then sales presentation means you have to present your product in such a way so that it will give a very persuasive message to the consumer to purchase your product. During the discussion, in any type of sales, the customer will have some query. That is known as objection handling. If you have the knowledge of your product and if you have knowledge of your company and other competitors, then I'm sure the salesman will be able to handle the objections very efficiently. And believe me, I have seen people in sales who are doing fairly well. Those people who are very good at handling objections, they are very good salesperson because they close sales. Once you close sales, that means you have procured business for your organization and you will excel like anything. And post sale follow-up means after selling the product, be in touch with the consumer so that the consumer will feel privileged. The consumer will think that yes, after the purchase, the company cares about me, and that gives an immense satisfaction to the consumer. And while we are talking about the salesman, what should be the qualities of a good salesperson? Theoretically, there are lots of qualities, and if one follows that, then he or she may appear like a god. Practically, this is not possible. The basic qualities of a good salesperson should be to be patient, to be decent in appearance. Decent in appearance means he should not look dirty, should be wearing clean clothes, he should be punctual, he should stick to his commitment, if he is not fulfilling any commitment, he should communicate it properly to the prospect about the delay and should postpone it to another date with conversation with the consumer. He should have knowledge of the product and of the company. He should have that hunger within himself to excel, to attain some good positions in the society, in the organization also. So there are lots of qualities described in your book. But the main things you can write from yourself, what you think should be best for a salesperson. Just remember two or three things in addition to all your assumed characteristics or qualities. A salesperson should be very patient, should have adequate knowledge to handle any objection, and he should be ready to listen, to accept the denial from any consumer. That is a very weak thing. Because if you approach someone, if he agrees to purchase your product, you feel happy. But if the consumer denies to buy your product, then somewhat you feel bad and you carry a very bad impression of that consumer. That should not happen. So you should be ready to accept the denial. Then we'll be going to sales promotion. Just let me take a pause for a minute. I want to drink some water. Just a minute. Okay, then I am back. So now we will be discussing about sales promotion. We have discussed about the salesperson. Now we will discuss about sales promotion, because personal selling is over. Sales promotion basically refers to those activities other than all this, other than the components like personal selling, advertising, publicity. Sales promotion refers to those activities which enhances or stimulate consumer purchasing. That means which provokes the consumer to purchase the product. How it is done? Sales promotion through display. Through display of goods, either in showcases or in exhibitions or through demonstrations, and tagging some incentive, monetary benefit with the product. These activities provoke the consumer to purchase the product. That means by their display at different eminent places, the consumer feels good, and when he sees the attached offer, then he thinks of getting that product. So you know, sales promotion is basically an incentive given in different formats, but they are not permanent in nature. That means they are short-term offers. They will not be the same throughout the year. So what is the objective of sales promotion? To make more sell during a lean period. To motivate dealers to stock their products, stock the product of the organization more, because of because they are supposed to sell more because of the sales promotion activities. Sales promotion also builds goodwill of the organization. It attracts new customers. It also brings more customers to the stores by the offer displayed in the shop or in the market. So overall, it helps to motivate the sales force to achieve a higher target, because previously they were selling the product without any offer. Now they are given a weapon of discount or a promotional activity, a sales promotion, so that they will feel encouraged that yes, previously if at the price of 100 we were selling 200 units of this product, now with this offer definitely we are going to touch 400 or 500. So that boosts the morale of the sales force. Now we can discuss about some of the sales promotion methods, and many of these methods we have already discussed while we were discussing packaging. Let me recap some of those packaging, some of those offers. While we are studying packaging also, we discussed about this. One is price off. Price off means price is slashed from its normal price. You will be getting it at a reduced price. Similarly, quantity off. Quantity off means you will be getting 10% of more quantity or 20% of more quantity at the same rate. Then you can get the offer in packaged premium. Packaged premium means your offer will come with a gift inside the pack. There is also one other form which is known as banded premium. Banded premium means the product will remain in its container, remain in its pack, and the gift will be wrapped with the packet. That means the gift will be also visible to the customer. That is called your banded premium. Similarly, there is over-the-counter premium. Over-the-counter premium means you will purchase that product. At the time of paying the bill at the counter, you will get the additional gift. Similarly, there is a self-liquidating premiums. Self-liquidating premium means there will be an option for the consumer. Suppose a gift is coming with the product. If you don't want to take that gift, you will also be getting a discount for that. So that is self-liquidating premiums, like in form of coupons. They make self-promotion. There are many ways, by giving discounts, by locking draws among consumers. So by announcing dealer gifts, that means if the dealer will be able to sell a certain number of units, then the dealer will be rewarded. Usually will get some monetary benefit. So these are some forms of sales promotion. We already discussed many of these formats. The rest other things you can also go through your book and understand them, because they are not difficult to understand. Now we will move to the next unit, which will be your advertising and publicity. Now, advertising, as you know, is a paid form of mass communication with an identified sponsor. That means with an identified marketer, the organization which is actually making the advertisement to reach the consumer. So advertising is a paid form of non-personal communication. It has got two distinct objectives to achieve. One, it has to, the advertisement has to influence the consumer. It should persuade the consumer to go for that product and increase sales. Ultimate end of any activity in marketing is to promote sales, is to increase sales. So the advertising is not any exception from the prime objective of increasing sales. Through advertising, we can pursue or we can influence the consumer. So as you know, its objective would be to build awareness, is to create favorable attitude, that means pursue. And for the loyal consumers, it should reach them at regular intervals so that they will feel privileged that they are using your product. Otherwise, if the advertisement will not be repeated in a periodic manner, then the loyal consumer will somewhat think or somewhat take it in another way, that the company might have not been doing well. So there are several models which define about the objectives of advertising, but the basic thing you should remember, there is one model called AIDA model. AIDA means AIDA model, and all these letters represent a specific thing in marketing communication. AIDA means first, attention. You have to give attention to the consumers so that it will create an interest among them. Once they take interest in your product by constant persuasion, you may create a desire within themselves to go for your product, and the final action will be to final action of the consumer will be to purchase your product. So this is actually more or less related to the mindset, the psychological factors of human beings. So there are two or three models like AIDA model. There is another model which is called Levy's and Steiner model. This also concentrates first on awareness. Once you make the consumers aware, then you will build their knowledge on product. Once you build the knowledge, liking for your product will go up and they will prefer the purchase of your product. So now actually, we'll be discussing about the general objectives of advertising, how it is satisfied for different, how it is satisfied in different scenarios. Now you can think of the scenarios when an organization is launching a new product, advertising can be utilized to spread awareness. Similarly, when you are expanding your market to include new users, that means you are introducing a product which will add a new segment to your organization. In that case also, advertisement is done to appeal, to attract those particular segment of news of consumers. When you are supposed to make some special offer, in that case also advertisement comes in handy. To educate your customers on certain things, you need advertisement. So advertisement has lot of objectives depending on the particular aspect on which you want to communicate. When you are introducing a new product, it will be different. When you are trying to educate consumers on certain things, it will be different. When you are announcing a special offer, the message should be loud and clear and it should be expressed in a different way. So the role of advertising is to promote your sales, is to increase your sales so that you will derive more profit from your business. Now, when we have talked so much about advertisement, don't you think, and of course we are only discussing about the positive side of the advertisement, but don't you think there would be some criticism of advertising? Yes, there are some criticism for advertisement, and we will discuss some of the rational ones. We will not go into other criticizing statements. We'll only discuss about the rational ones. The more you advertise, or the more the organization advertises, it has to incur more cost, and that cost finally is paid by the customer. That means if you advertise more, the cost of your product will go up. For that reason, the customer may suffer. Second, the affluent companies, they go on advertising for their products n number of times, while the other companies who are not having sufficient funds with them lag much behind these bigger companies in terms of advertisement. So that actually an unfair play in the field of marketing, because those who are having lot, they are simply pursuing and creating more impact on the minds of consumers rather than those who are having less funds. So these are some of the criticisms of advertising. But there are certain benefits of advertising. Producers, they benefit from advertising. The intermediaries, they also get benefit from advertising because advertising makes their way much easier, makes the product known to the customer for which they can achieve more sales. Advertising is also beneficial for the customers to choose from a wide range of products, to compare the products, to analyze the products on the aspect of their quality, of the price. And as a whole, advertising also gives benefit to the community. Let me give you one or two examples. You are getting newspaper, and one newspaper costs you hardly 7 rupees, but in 7 rupees you are getting 16 pages of 4 times A4 size papers. That means if I calculate that, you are getting 64 pages of A4 printing at 7 rupees, which is not possible for any publication house to publish. This is only possible because of some government subsidy, and also for advertisement. These advertisements, because of the advertisement, newspapers are sold at a lower cost because the advertisements come in the newspaper. Similarly, this advertising system, which we will be reading just after this one, the advertising system, this is the system in which many people are working. That means advertising also creates employment for others. And in a country like us, if an institution or because of some activities, if employment is created, then it is always welcome. So when we are talking of employment, we must know which major institutions play their role in advertising. Not difficult to understand. In advertising, there will be an advertiser who will be paying, who will be sponsoring the advertisement. That means the company. How the company will do that? The company itself cannot do all the activities. It has focused all its work on production of a particular products or a product line. So it seeks the help of an advertising agency who are expert in this field, or an advertising agency who is rendering its service in this particular field for a longer period of time. So there is need of an advertising agency who are specialist in this field. Then some support organizations will be needed. Why this support organization? Support organization means they are not part of the organization. Neither they are part of the manufacturer, nor they are the part of the advertising agency. They are independent variable, independent identities. Suppose like photographers. If you are shooting something, you will call those professional persons to take your snaps. Suppose you are doing some audio video editing. For that, you have to take the help of specialized person in that segment. So they are play the role of support organization. So we have so far discussed three main part of the advertising process, then in the institutions that are involved in advertising. One is your sponsor, the advertiser, the company. Second, it does the advertisement with the help of an advertising agency. During the preparation of the advertisement, they take the help of support organizations like photographer, like video editors, like audio editors. Then after they prepare the advertisement, they go for media. Media means on which channel they want to advertise. What is their price? How many times they are going to repeat your advertisement? For which price? So all these things are decided. For that, they need a media. And finally, the output should reach the target audience. That means the consumer. So these are the major institutions or major players involved in advertising. How does this advertising process take place? Now let us take a break, because I think I will complete. Before that, I should take some break. And so far, whether Mukesh, am I going too fast, or is it understood, or okay thing?
No, sir, it is very much understood, sir.
Okay, then Pinky, are you there? Hello. Pinky has got some problem with her mic. Every time she wants to speak something, but it is not audible to me. Surbhi, is it okay?
Yes, sir. It is fine.
Okay, then. We'll move forward. We'll move with advertising process. So process, advertising process, for advertising, actual advertising process relies on five types of decision. What is the mission? What is the objective? This is one decision, what to achieve. Then second, the decision on budget will be made. Then what message to be delivered, to be communicated. Then decision on media will be taken. Then another thing, because we many times we have discussed about the objective decision, what the organization wants to achieve, objective decision, budgetary decision, how much the organization can afford or can spend for the advertisement. Then what message it wants to communicate to the consumers, we discussed that. Then media decision, through which media it will advertiser communicate. Another one comes in this advertising process, the decision on measurement of effectiveness. This is very important, because you suppose you have the money, you clearly state your objectives, you have the budget, you have designed your message, you have chosen the media, you advertised your product in the media. But how much it is effective, it will only be known from the sales. If after your advertisement, sales go up, then you will find that yes, our advertisement is effective. So that should be measured. So we will be discussing about that particular aspect, which is not discussed earlier. Because other things we have discussed, the media decision, where to advertise it, whether it is newspaper, whether it is magazines, whether it is radio, whether it is television, whether by mail. So those things we have discussed many times. Or shall I repeat those things? I don't think that. Well, for media, just I am giving you two or three things. Once you decide on media, you have to ensure two or three things. How media is decided? First, you have to choose a media so that it will reach maximum number of consumers. But the media which reaches maximum number of consumers has a higher rate, higher charges. So keeping the price range in your mind, you have to go for a media for which you can afford, and at the same time you can cover a larger population. Second, for media scheduling, you have to ensure the price you are paying, for that price, how many times your ad is going to be displayed or printed, the frequency, how many times the ad will be displayed throughout the year, and in how much interval. And third thing in media scheduling is your media timing. Media timing means most of you are working, or you are very much engaged specifically within 10, from 10 morning 10 to 2 o'clock in the afternoon, in the midday. If during that period of time, 10 to 2 o'clock, if the advertisement comes on TV, then obviously not more number of consumers will see that. So timing is also important. Your advertisement should come at such a time so that maximum number of consumers will get to know about your product. So in media scheduling, you have to consider three things. What is the reach of that material? With the amount you are paying, what would be the frequency of your advertisement throughout the years and the interval of depression and the timing, the slot at in which your advertisement will come in the media. Now, what I said before, I want to discuss about the measurement of effectiveness. That is an important part. Once you advertise, you should know how much you have influenced the buyer to go for your product. So there are two methods actually. One is pre-testing method and the other one is post-testing method. Pre-testing method, it is adapted by almost all companies because you know advertising involves a lot of cost. So without testing the testing the impact of a media, you cannot go for full commercialized advertisements. Keeping that thing in mind, marketers first get a pre-testing. That means they advertise on a particular media for a shorter period of time and spend less for that. If after that short advertisements, short in terms of frequency, that means they are not repeated more than they did not prolong for a longer period of time, they are like 2 months, 3 months. Small frequency. And spend huge amount on advertising campaign without testing the effectiveness of the advertisement or the media. The post-testing method is that once an advertisement has been in the chosen media and you have got the right timing, now it is time to measure the awareness level of the consumers. There is a model which is called TOMA model, T-O-M-A, in its short form known as TOMA. It is known as top of mind awareness, top of the mind awareness. How does it work? Let me give you. This is a four-step method. First, let us assume that the consumers are totally unaware of your brand, of your product. First stage, they are totally unaware. The customers. Through advertisement, you make your brand known to them. That means your brand gets a small recognition after certain advertisements. Then, after repetition of advertisement, your brand becomes familiar to them. That means at any point of time, if your logo or if the fast line comes in the advertisement, they immediately recognize your brand. That's called brand recall. First they were unaware, then you make your brand known to them, then you make your brand familiar to them. So once you make your brand familiar to them, then it occupies a place in their mind that is called top of the mind awareness toma. So this is also a post-test method for the effectiveness of advertisement. Now we will move to the last part of this unit, publicity. We have already discussed, we don't have to spend publicity. If you differentiate in advertising and publicity, you will be very clear. As publicity, you will draw the attention of media. So they will write about you in their newspaper, or they will picturize a video on your activities. That means when you are doing something which is something extra, something extraordinary, something other than your usual work, which draws attention of the media. When you are organizing an event, when you are doing a cultural activities for the inhabitants of the surroundings, when you are felicitating some bright students, you are getting attention of the media, and they publish from their side about you. So basic difference between advertising and publicity is that for advertising you pay, for publicity you don't have to pay. In advertising, the sponsor, the manufacturer, he determines the message, what to be written, what to be communicated. But in publicity, sponsor has nothing to interfere. It is entirely managed by the publication department of the media house. Then content in case of advertising, content is developed by the advertiser, by the manufacturer. But in publicity, content is developed by the media source. Similarly, you can schedule your advertisement in a particular media, a particular timing, but publicity comes in the media once they are not repetitive in nature. And if you compare from one aspect, that is called credibility, that means which is more reliable, which is more appealing to the customer, which will be more credible. You believe me, in case of credibility, even if you pay for advertisement, advertising has low to moderate credibility because the organization is paying for that. So the advertisement is designed as per the requirement of the, or as per the wish of the organization. But publicity, because it is voluntarily written by a media, it has high credibility. That's why all the bigger organizations, they do some social activities, social welfare work to gain attention of media. And publicity you can get through press conference, your website, by your cultural activities. So this is all about your publicity and advertising. Now we'll just discuss about some emerging issues in marketing in the current scenario, and we'll try to find some solutions to that, so that we'll be completing the paper. And I'm happy that I'm running within the time, and we will definitely complete it. So the emerging issues means, what are the difficulties, what are the challenges marketing, challenges in the field of marketing, and how can we manage that? Well, in marketing, relationship matters, because relationship with a core group of customers contributes a lot to your business. So it is the responsibility of the organization to make that customers, the core group of customers, feel good about the company. So they should be in personal connection, constant touch with those bunch of consumers to excel in business. In this relationship, what are the basic elements? The basic elements are, one is you identify your customers, and you should have the customer database with whom you will be maintaining a long-term relationship. Let me give you some examples. On the eve of some special occasions, like Diwali, like Dasara, like the Independence Day, some organizations wish to the public. That is one of the forms of maintaining relationship with the consumers. Those consumers who are loyal to that organization feel something good about that organization. Yes, it is advertising for the same country. It is not only wishing us, but also wishing all the citizens of India. It's a good thing. They feel somewhat good within themselves. Then, whatever target market you have chosen, you have to deliver, you have to go on delivering differentiated messages. It means you should always picturize that you care for them because they are valuable to you. This is a very important element of relationship. Whoever you are entering a relation, at some point of time, within certain intervals, you have to give a feeling to that person that yes, you mean a lot to me. You are somewhat special to me. That feeling drives a good relation. So these are some of the elements of relationship which ends up in having good increased business. You have to maintain that relationship with customers. Similarly, you have to maintain relationship with the intermediaries. That means the wholesaler, the retailers. They are the ones who are carrying for your business forward. In the same way, you also give them benefit. You also make them a part of your celebrations inside the factory premises. In that case, you can maintain a good relationship with everyone and you'll be successful in your business. Now, in case of service, what will be the marketing challenges? In case of services, marketing is, I think we have already discussed in this, because services are intangible. Services are heterogeneous because all the time you will not be exactly the same in delivering service. So you have to be careful so that whatever services you render, it should be all the time, it should be appreciated, it should be praised by the customers, or services should satisfy the customers. As you know, services are intangible, but services rendered by human beings. So as an organization, you should take special care of those people who are delivering the services for you, who are rendering the services for you. That means you should have special training for those persons. You should motivate them from time to time. For your work, you have to prepare them fully for your service, so that it will end up in customer satisfaction. Because services purely depend on the personnel through which they are delivered. So the organization should take good care while recruiting those people, not compromising on any of the aspects, any of the qualities which are not found in a particular candidate. The organization should not compromise on that. Rather, it should stick to some of the basic qualities which a candidate should possess, so that train and develop that person to be a good service provider. Now, what are the other issues in marketing? Summer is where with the evolution of internet and is available worldwide, the local vendors, they are facing some problem. So the organizations, whether small or large, should go physicalization, should play as per the rules, as per the trend in the market, should be technology percent, should try to adopt new technology in their workplace, so that they can also follow the same route and act the challenges that is coming in their way of this small organization. Because internet marketing with web designing, web strategies, even the small companies, they are doing well. And their advertising purpose, internet is also playing a good role, must have experienced that while you are searching through Google, when you are opening Google Chrome and searching through Google, even if you are into your mail or even if you are opening a site, some small pops are coming in the right side of the screen, and every time you have to close it, those are a part of web advertisement. So advertisement has come a long way, and the objective is to make the product or make the organization familiar to the audience, but long run, they can end up in pursuing good business for the organization. And now another issue in marketing is that the green marketing concept is evolving in the world. Green marketing means you should care your environment. So sticking to the satisfaction of those customers by compiling their queries regarding the product, which is not causing any destruction to the environment, not causing anything, not causing any damage to the environment. What I mean to say, now consumers are aware of environment. They want those products to be purchased, those products which are not causing any damage to the environment during their process of production. So that should be taken into account, the green marketing challenges that the consumer can get the product they are looking for, and the organizations they will produce by abiding all the environmental laws. And there is also another thing, they should understand their social responsibility in contributing their part to make the environment safe for everyone. Similarly, there is issues in rural marketing. The main issue is that, as you know, 70% of our population still live in rural areas. But rural market has not gone supposed. All the marketing, all the advertisements are done by keeping the urban population in mind. So the rural people, their need also is growing. The organizations should take proper care to address those 70% population. Their marketing communication should reach these customers, so that their needs will be fulfilled. They also want to go for sophisticated products. They also want to live a lifestyle of those in the urban areas. because their exposure is small, the marketers should take care to participate in their weekly market, in their areas, through different outlets, through it should reach them through the medium which is plentifully accessible to them, like the local TV channel, like the regional news channel. They should want to address those issues. If these issues are addressed, then also marketers can penetrate firmly in the rural areas through the advertisement. So with this, I come to the end of your entire marketing management paper. I am happy that I am able to complete all the blocks and all the units, of course, with supportive actions. So thank you all once again for being with me the last 6-7 days. Now, the last time, some of you can interact with me before I leave the session. So I should start from Suri.
Yes, sir.
The last time I am interacting. So may you do well in the exam. May you clear your papers so that you will add some more ornament to your education. And we wish you the best to clear your papers. Thanks for Chandrakanta, Mukesh.
Thank you so much. Singh. Thank you. I hope that this time the marketing paper, it would be very easy for me.
Now, once you get your concept clear, you can write. I know that. So, all the best to everyone.
Thank you so much, sir. Gave us so precious time of yours and made the concept so clear in our mind. Thank you so much, sir. It really
Most welcome. So, thank you so much, everyone. And especially you. You were present for all sessions.
Because I need
Let's hope for the best.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
And I wish you a very bright career. Do and prosper in whatever you are doing. Do well.
Yes, sir. Thank
Be
you.
Be blessed. And all the best. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot.
Goodbye, everyone.
Goodbye.